Good morning students, welcome to your mathematics class. So we have finished HCF, LCF by using 3 meters. And now today's topic is divisibility rules. Already you have studied, 6th class students already have studied in your 5th class. For 5th class it is new for, okay. So divisibility rules, what are these divisibility rules? Suppose a number is given. Now if I want to check whether that number is divisible by 2 or 3 or 4, what I will do? Definitely I will go for a division, right? Suppose 345 is there. Now I want to divide with 2. So the only method which you know is division. So I will go for the division. 3 minus 2, 1, copy 4, 2 7s are 40, 0, copy 5, 2 2s are 4, remainder 1. So when you are getting remainder 1 means we can say that this particular number is not divisible by 2. If you are getting remainder 0 means I can say that this particular number is divisible by this number. Yes. But by using these rules, divisibility rules, without doing your actual division, you can say that whether a given number is divisible by a particular number or not. Clear? So you no need to go for the division process by seeing 345. So here I am not doing any division. I can say that this number is not divisible by 2. How means? By using your divisibility rules. What are those? We'll see now. Okay. So here it is the definition of the divisibility rule. The process of checking whether a number is divisible by a given number or not without actual division. So we are not performing any division here. By seeing the number, by applying the divisibility rule, we can say that a number is divisible or not. This is called your divisibility rule for that number. Clear? Now, we'll start with the divisibility by 2. Okay? First one is divisibility by 2. Divisibility by 2. So, what is the divisibility rule for 2? A number is divisible by 2 if it has any one of the digits zero, two, four, six, or 8 in its ones place. In its ones place. This is your divisibility rule for 2. I will read. A number is divisible by 2 if it has any of the digits 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8 in its ones place. Okay. So I will explain you this with an example. Suppose I am taking 2, 4, 5, 6. This is my number. So 2456. Now I want to check whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. So here I am not doing any division process. Once you see the divisibility by 2, what should be there? In ones place, either 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. Any one of the digits must be there. If you have these digits means, definitely the number is divisible by 2. Okay. So here comes your solution. Okay. The given number is 2456. Now what you have to check? In ones place whether these digits are there or not, you have to check. Now copy the number 2456. As you know the place values well, so starting from ones place, from where we will start? From the right. So ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Right? Now you underline the ones place. What is there in ones place? 6.
Now, is my sixes there in the room?
Yes.
0, 2, 4, 6. Okay. So, if answer place 6 is there, means I can say that this whole number is divisible by 2. Clear? Alright. In ones place 6 is there. In ones place 6 is there. So, the given number 2456 is divisible by 2. Divisible by 2. Now here I will give you one more number. Now you have to tell me, suppose 12,457. This is my number. 12,457. Okay. So what is the rule? In ones place, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 must be there. Now you underline the ones place. What is there in ones place? 7 is there. So 7 is not divisible. 7 is, as 7 is not there in the room, so 7 is not divisible by 2. So when 7 is not divisible by 2, the whole number is not divisible by 2. So here you can add one more also. 6 is divisible by 2. Yes. Yes, what is the quotient? Quotient is equal to 3, remainder is equal to 0. This trick also you have to write. 6 divisible by 2. Yes, quotient is equal to 3, r is equal to 0. Now here comes your second example. Okay. Now what you have to write? Solution. Given number is 12,457. Now you write down the number 12,457, underline the 7. So write down, in ones place 7 is there. In ones place 7 is there. Now you check, is 7 divisible by 2? No, 7 is not divisible by 2. In the rule also 7 is not there. So 7 is not divisible by 2. Therefore, or else, so The given number 12,457 is not divisible by 2. This is how you have to check whether a given number is divisible by a particular number or not by not doing any division. Clear, children? So you take your own number, 5 digit, 6 digit, 3 digit, 4 digit number you take and try to find whether that number is divisible by 2 or not. Okay? Copy this. So children, already we have seen the divisibility by 2. Now, the next rule is divisibility by 8. So for each number, we have the separate rule. For each number, we have to separate them and don't get confused, and you have to learn these divisibility rules perfectly now. Okay? Why? Because again these rules are there in your 8th class, 9th also you are going to use this. Okay? Now what the divisibility by 3 says is, a number is divisible by 3 if the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 3. Okay? Sum of the digits means you have to add the digits in a number. Why we have to go with the sum of the digits means, if you consider the 3 table, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15, 3 sixes are 18, 3 sevens are 21, up to 21 I have taken. Now, 3 ones are 3, 3 is divisible by 3. If you take 6, it means 6 is divisible by 3. If you take 9, means divisible by 2. Now coming to 12 is also divisible by 2. But a short method is, if you add 1 plus 2, how much? 3. 3 is divisible by 3. Now 1 plus 5, 6. 1 plus 8, 9. 2 plus 1, 3. Means if you add the digits in a number, the sum is also divisible by 3. Now understood? I have taken 12, now you add up 1
is also divisible by 3. Understood? Now we'll take an example and we'll see whether the number is divisible by 3 or not. Okay? Suppose example, check is 78741 is divisible by 3 or not. This is my question. Here comes your solution. Now write down the given number is, the given number is, what is the given number? 78741. What we have to find here? Sum of the digits. Sum of the digits means sum of the digits. Sum of the digits. Sum means you have to add up each digit, that is 7 plus 8 plus 7 plus 4 plus 1. Now add up how much? 7 plus 8, 15. 15 plus 7, 22. 22 plus 4, 26. 26 plus 1, 27. Now again you add up these two. 2 plus 7, how much? 9. Now you check. Is 9 divisible by 3? Is 9 divisible by 3? Yes, 3 3 is a 9. So it is divisible. Quotient is 3, remainder is 0. So when 9 is divisible by 3, when 9 is divisible by 3, so the entire number, that is 78741, is also divisible, is also divisible by 3. See how simple it is. Here I am not doing any division process. Simply I have added the given digits of a number and I am checking whether this is divisible by 3 or not. Yeah, it is divisible. So I can write the whole number is also divisible by 3. Clear, children? The same process you can take it for another number which is not divisible by 3. I hope you people have understood. You have to do more practice on these divisibility rules now. Clear? Thank you. Have a nice day.